One day, quantum computers will be able to solve some of humanity's hardest problems. This is our hope. You can solve problems that classical computers can't with relatively few quantum bits. But qubits are fragile. They suffer from errors.
The biggest problem is the incredible quantity of resources needed to correct these errors. About 1,000 individual qubits are needed to achieve perfection, to create one error-free logical qubit. It's like needing a whole orchestra to play one flawless note.
The infrastructure to control a single logical qubit is already large, and you would need hundreds of logical qubits for the first useful applications to things like fundamental research in physics or chemistry. But for truly groundbreaking applications, you would need tens of thousands. The engineering and financial challenge becomes almost unbearable at this point.
Cat qubits offer a distinct advantage over standard qubits. They are protected against one dimension of noise by design, so we are left with only one dimension to be corrected. This makes error correction much, much simpler. A few years ago, cat qubits were only a nice theoretical concept. Today, we implement and run them every day in the lab.
To run complex algorithms like Shor's, you need several million standard qubits. But using cat qubit instead, you would reduce this number by up to 60 times.
Thanks to these savings, quantum computing becomes a more realistic goal that we can reach sooner. But can we do better?
So there's a type of error-correcting codes called low-density parity check that can save up a lot of resources. They were invented in the 60s, and today they're used for Wi-Fi, for 5G, and many other cutting-edge technologies. So the idea is to create extra connections between distant qubits to get more out of them.
But if you want to make quantum LDPC codes, things are not that straightforward. With standard qubits, theoretical work has already shown promising results using quantum LDPC codes. You will need 15 times less hardware for error correction.
However, it's extremely challenging to achieve such long-range qubit connectivity, and nobody has yet found a convincing way to run logical gates on these codes. You just can't operate your quantum computer anymore.
The current challenge in quantum computing is to reduce the number of qubits you need, and both cat qubits and LDPC codes can do that. The intuition was there from the beginning. Can we combine these two? And how far does this take us?
There's a theory, okay, but we don't only need the math to work. We want our engineers to be able to build this machine and our physicists to run it. Connectivity must be simplified. Yet, mathematical proofs show that you can't avoid complex connections, except if we use a one-dimensional code, such as the one cats use.
Cat qubits are arranged in a line, but even then, adding these long-range connections is still a mess, unless you fold that line. Then, distant qubits become neighbors, which are now easy to connect.
The first codes we tried were, well, horrible. A dead end. We dived into tens of possible codes that kind of worked, but we still couldn't find one worth the effort.
Then we started optimizing things. We went through billions of different designs to get an efficient code. A code that would need a low number of qubits and still allow us to run operations on them.
Yes, we spent a lot of time on it.
Finally, we found the optimal one, a simple pattern enabling us to run error correction with 5 times less qubits.
Cat qubits alone are already quite efficient in reducing the hardware requirements to build a useful quantum computer. But combined with LDPC codes, the savings are drastic.
Many smart people in the lab are working hard to link these technologies and make a processor we can use on real-life problems. The first real-world applications might be much closer than we think, with hardware that we could build today.
One day, quantum computers will finally be useful, and this could come really soon.